If you don't have a man at home, you know, who lifts weights at Planet Fitness, you need a foot massage machine. You know, if you don't have life insurance or health insurance, at least have a toe cushion on your toe. Please get the right heel size. Hello everybody, welcome back to another Heat Heels video. I'm going to be giving you 10 high heel hacks to make wearing heels so much more comfortable. If you guys are a subscriber to my channel, you probably know that I made a previous video talking about some different high heel hacks that you can use to enhance your mobility and your comfort when wearing high heels. But this video is going to be more in-depth. I'm going to be giving you some brand new products and hacks for making your high heels much more comfortable and easier to wear. So if you're new to my channel, my name is He Heels, and I upload entertaining and informative content to help you become the greatest version of yourself. So if you love a good pair of high heel stilettos, subscribe down below, follow me on Instagram at He Heels. All of my links, including all of the products that I mentioned in today's video, will be inside of my description box below. I will also have a blog post written on my website at heheels.com, so you can check that out as well to get a more written version of this video. Today's featured heel is an AliExpress heel. This is 7 inches, a 7-inch pump. I absolutely love these. I love how the back heel is reflective and the rest of it is kind of a different design, you know, a cool pattern. So you can purchase these in my description box below. Be sure to also subscribe to my emails on my blog at heheels.com to receive a free ebook showing you how to walk in heels. I am literally putting this ebook together for you guys for free and teaching you guys how to walk in heels step by step and giving you exclusive tips. So go to my blog, heheels.com, and sign up. Well, that being said, let's go ahead and get started with these high heel hacks. The first high heel hack to make your high heels more comfortable will have to be to use CBD cream on your feet. This stuff works wonders, you guys. If you have feet that ache after you wear heels, or maybe you have some points of your shoe that just make you feel like you're hurting to death, I would highly recommend using CBD cream, because if you don't know what CBD actually is, CBD is an extractive from the cannabis plant. So it's basically marijuana's long lost cousin 3 times removed. It doesn't get you high like weed does, but it seeps into your pores and alleviates all types of tension and pain within your feet. So I highly recommend that you get this. You can also use it on your pussy, you can use it on your dick, or whatever you want to. It really works to alleviate stress and tension throughout your entire body, not just your feet. I have personally used this on my feet several times. I do have some heels that are way too small for me, simply because when I was starting out on my high heel wearing journey, I didn't understand how to measure my feet. And that's actually gonna be one of my next tips that I'm gonna talk about. But I had some shoes that were too small. I ordered them from AliExpress, but nonetheless, I still wore them because I wanted to look cute, and I ended up suffering because of that. But CBD cream has definitely helped me, so check that out in the description box below. My next tip will be to use a gel sock pad. Now, this is basically an accessory that covers your entire foot and allows you to be comfortable in any shoe or boots that you wear. I actually had somebody in my comment section talking about how he's a straight male who wears work boots, but my last video giving you high heel hacks actually helped him because he used the gel socks. So get those in my description box below as well. These have been a lifesaver for me, simply because I've had platform shoes that are too hard inside. So the material is like pleather, you know, it's really tough. Plus it has that platform and it's a single sole shoe. So I have to wear gel socks. So get that in my description box as well. Now the gel sock pad does come in different forms. So you can get a package that includes ones that just cover the front part of your feet, so just your toes. You can get one that just covers one side, and there's so many different kinds. So be sure to check that out in my description box. Now my next heel hack will be to have toe numbing cream. This stuff works wonders because it tranquilizes your toes. So if you have hammer toes, if you have bunions and funyuns and Cheetos and Fritos all in between your toes, you need some toe numbing cream, because this stuff basically tranquilizes your toes for about an hour or two so that you can wear your heels comfortably. And it has definitely worked for me. I personally don't use it all the time because I know how to buy shoes that are comfortable for me. I know how to measure my feet and get the right size. But if you are someone who is struggling with that, Be sure to get some toe numbing cream, especially if you are new to wearing heels, because it will help you out, especially in the beginning stages of your high heel wearing journey. My next high heel hack, I have 10, so bear with me. Heel arch supports. There are products designed specifically to support your feet when you are wearing hard to wear shoes. They can get kind of complicated, so I will have my favorite one in the description box below, but it's basically a bandage or a band that you wrap around your feet, or a concoction that you slip into that supports your feet whenever you wear high heels. So it keeps your feet in the most optimal position for comfort when you start to walk in your stilettos or even wedges if you struggle with that as well. My next high heel hack would be foot massage machine. This is essential for wearing high heels and recovering for the next day. So if you're wearing high heels back to back, let's just say you're a drag queen, let's just say you're Beyonce, let's just say you're somebody who's having shows and you have to wear high heels frequently, you gotta have that recovery period. You know, you need a massage. You gotta have your feet just pampered and loved up on, because high heels hurt your feet, period. Even if it's the right size, it's strenuous. This is not natural. High heels are not natural. So you need something to alleviate that stress. And if you don't have a man at home, you know, who lifts weights at Planet Fitness, you need a foot massage machine. And it may be quite an investment, but it's one that I would definitely invest in, simply because you need to pamper yourself. We are willing to invest in all types of different companies every day. Why not invest in your own health? Why not invest in your wellness? Why not invest in your feet, your bunions, your hammer toes? Invest in that, okay? Get yourself a foot massage machine in my description box below. Heel hack number 6 would be get high quality heels. I'm gonna list a few stores. So my favorite one is Only Maker, of course. I always mention Only Maker. The next store is, of course, AliExpress, my first store that I ever purchased heels off of. You can find all sorts of heels in different sizes and different heights. If you haven't seen my video where I walked in 9-inch heels at Walmart and Target as well, those were my most popular heels, and I got those from AliExpress. Those are a dagger thin stiletto that are 9 inches tall and a size 15 or 16 in women. So I really love those heels. Those are my favorite and most sturdy to date. You will find some heels that aren't as sturdy and well put together on AliExpress, but you know, it's China. No, you're getting high quality heels for a decent price. You know, those only cost me like $50, but if you were in person seeing those heels, you would probably think they cost way more. My next store would definitely have to be, I hate to say it, but Pleaser USA. I mean, I don't have anything against them, but a lot of their heels just aren't in my size, but they are starting to get a lot more selections available in my size, size 15 in women. So they are trying to be more inclusive, which I can appreciate. And I also found 2 new stores, discountstripper.com and Shoe Cup. I think that's what it's called, Shoe Strip, whatever. I will have it in my description box below, but I found some brand new stores for you guys. So be sure to go all in my description box and read it like a book, because I'm gonna have it decked out for you. High heel hack number 7 would be to have some toe cushions on hand at all times. Toe cushions wrap around your toes and protect them from strappy sandals that will cut you like a knife. If you are walking outside in the summertime, you just had a cheeseburger, okay, a vegan cheeseburger, you're sweating out your pores and your feet are slipping and sliding everywhere, sandals will cut you like nothing else on earth. You know that pinky toe that sticks out at the front part of your sandal heel? That's the worst, you guys. You want to make sure you have a toe cushion to protect you. You know, if you don't have life insurance or health insurance, at least have a toe cushion on your toe. You know, it's painful. You know, just saying. I mean, this is a simple one. Just wear some socks, because I don't know about you guys, but I found that if I wear a nice pair of wool socks and a pair of heels, they kind of act like a gel cushion, but just a low budget ghetto version, you know, that the food stamp fraud version. But they actually do work, especially if you are dancing. If you have a good boot on that has a sharp stiletto, it will be best to wear some socks with it. I mean, it's kind of common sense. If you are someone who despises looking at socks with heels, I would recommend that you wear footies instead of tube socks. I hate the way tube socks with heels look as well. You can also wear jeans over your socks to kind of make it look a little better. Of course, you can always wear a high heel boot or a bootie to cover everything. Number 9 would be to get the right size. This is the most important out of all of the other hacks. If you don't have the right size, these tips aren't even gonna help you. They're not even gonna go far because you don't have the right size. You're squeezing into your shoes, you're not feeling comfortable, you're not gonna be able to walk right, you're gonna look like a penguin. Please get the right heel size, people. People are always in the comment section asking me about what size should I get. It's up to your measurements. You have to get a ruler, you have to get down and dirty, no condom, raw, on the floor, measure your foot size and go 2 sizes up from that. If you're on AliExpress, look at the sizing charts. There are charts on there that are created specifically for you to reference. Do not go by store size. Size 5, size 12, none of that. Look at the charts and look at the centimeters and the inches of the length of the shoe and go by that. For example, my feet are exactly 12 inches long, 1 foot long. So I know to get a shoe that is at least 12 inches long. Even better, 12.5, so I can have a little extra wiggle room. Sometimes it really depends on how they make the shoe, because the shoe may run small, the shoe may run large, but you know that the foot is 12 inches, so that should be the base.
Period.
For how you purchase your heel size. My last and final heel hack for you guys will have to be wear platforms instead of no platform heels. Heels with platforms are a lot more comfortable than heels without platforms, simply because they give you a little extra boost and they also, you know, give you a little leverage to stand on versus just walking on hard ground. So if you are someone who is just starting out wearing high heels, I would highly recommend you wear platforms. Don't go for like the 8-inch platforms. Try to go for more, you know, 3-inch, 4-inch, even 5-inch. Keep it low, keep it steady. Now, you can make not wearing platforms more comfortable for you if you have the gel socks that I mentioned earlier in this video, but you can also wear regular socks as well. But I would recommend wearing platforms in general, just because they give you a little extra something to stand on so that you aren't walking on, you know, hard rocks or nails, or you don't trip on things easier. Platforms versus no platforms do have their disadvantages and advantages, but overall, platforms are a great start. Well, you guys, that is it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. Go ahead and give this video a big old thumbs up if you liked it, because it helps me out so much in the YouTube algorithm out here on these YouTube streets. It's a struggle every day constantly. So give it a big old thumbs up. Be sure to comment below and let me know what you guys think about these heel hacks. Which one is most beneficial to you? You know, do you have any tips as well? What kind of shoes do you prefer? And I will see you in my next video. Peace.